लैब जंक्शंस, ऑटो कार्ल फिशर टाइट्रीमीटर मॉडल LJ761 फॉर डिटरमिनेशन ऑफ मॉइस्चर इन मेडिसिंस एंड ऑयल। दिस इज आवर मेन इंस्ट्रूमेंट, दिस इज द फ्रंट पैनल। इन दिस दिस बटन इज फॉर स्टरिंग ऑन और ऑफ। दिस इज स्टरिंग स्पीड। दिस इंडिकेटर इज फॉर बजर ऑफ। दिस इंडिकेटर इज फॉर स्टार्ट एंड दिस इंडिकेटर इज फॉर स्टॉप। नाउ दिस इज द टाइमर। इफ यू वांट टू चेंज योर एनालिसिस टाइम ऑफ एंड पॉइंट, इफ यू नीड 2 seconds, then please set on 2 seconds. If you need analysis time 15 seconds, you set on 15. If you want 30, you set on 30. If you want to need 60 seconds, you set on this 60, like this way. Then your analysis will take 60 seconds. If you set on 30, your analysis will take on 30 seconds to getting final endpoint. Same, this is 15. Now I'm setting on 2. In the pharmacy and pharmaceutical companies always recommend for 15 seconds, like this way. Now this is the top view. This is spaces for reservoir bottle and this spaces for titration vessel. This is solenoid valve. This is the heart of the instrument. Back view, side view, again back view. These are the 2 banana socket pins for Carl Fischer electrode. This is control is for switching on or off. Again side view. With this instrument, we supply accessories. Unit 1 is main instrument and unit 2 is auto zero bullet assembly of 10 ml. Now, supplied accessories are, these are the supplied accessories. In this, rubber ballo for auto zero bearing. Extra reagent tube. Dropper for sampling 2 numbers. Magnetic capsule or bead for titration vessel. Cotton for moisture trap of burette. Carl Fischer electrode. Instruction manual of instrument with dust cover of instrument and 1 year warranty card. Now, how to assemble and use this Lab Junction's auto Carl Fisher titrimeter? For analysis, you have to need, first is Carl Fisher solution wiry drain free. Methanol specially dried. And third one is silica gel for moisture trap of auto zero burette. Now, how to assemble this? First, you have fill Carl Fisher reagent in reservoir bottle. Now, add 150 ml methanol specially dried. You have to keep on this space of titration vessel. Now fit burette assembly of auto zero burette. Now this is the part one of auto zero burette. You have to fit on this piece like this. Part 2 of auto zero burette like this way. Now, these are the three clamps for fitting of auto zero burette, and this is the moisture trap, and this gusset is for rubber bellow. Now, how to fit? In the moisture trap, first you have fit cotton, and in the top side you have to insert silica gel for non-removing of dry air. You have to fit like this. Now, you have to fit like this. fit this clamp like this way. Now, fit rubber bellow. Like this. Now, this is the main heart of Auto-Carl Fischer Titanometer solar valve. This is the upper end. This is the lower end. Upper end, this is the upper end. You have to fit on the burette. Like this way. Now, this is the lower end. Lower end, you have to fit on the titration vessel. Like this. Now fit Carl Fischer electrode to the instrument. You have to insert like this. And connect its banana socket on the back side. This is the final assembly. First, you have open the auto zero burette mouth like this way. Now, fill Carl Fischer reagent in the auto zero burette. First, you have to close this burette mouth like this with the finger and press rubber bellow like this. Now, this is the final assembly of Auto-Carl Fischer titrimeter. Please check. These are the three clamps fitted like this. Now, insert your magnetic capsule like this way. Like this way. I am already inserted. Now start your magnetic stirrer. Now I am starting it on 15 seconds. Analysis time for endpoint. Now I am, please fill this burette like this way. You have to like finger this and push rubber bellow. Release that. Auto zero will be red. Automatically set to zero. Now press start key. Now my end point comes. It means my solution in the titration vessel is neutralized. It is completely free from moisture. Now again I am refilling auto zero burette like this way. You have to finger like this. Release that. it automatically starts to 0. Now, suppose this is my sample. You open the mouth of titration vessel. Insert your sample. Please give 5 minutes to dissolve your sample in the titration vessel. Like this. Now, please check the bureau rating. This is 0. Now press start key and complete overview. You see that. Now, my endpoint comes of my sample. I'm buzzer off. Now, please check the bureau rating. This is 5.1, 2, 3, 4, 5.3. My bureau rating is 5.3. Now, you see this. This is the calculation method of moisture content. Calculation. Percentage of moisture content is equal to Kf in ml multiply MDF multiply 100 divided by weight of the sample in milligram. What is MDF? MDF is moisture determining factor of Carl Fisher in milligram per ml. What is Kf? Kf is equal to Carl Fisher reagent used. If you want to take your MDF on, then MDF is equal to percentage of moisture content multiply weight of the sample in milligram divided by Carl Fisher in ml multiply 100. If you want to take default MDF, please check your own Carl Fisher solution bottle like this. This is 5 milligram water. Now, how to calculate? You have to calculate. Suppose 5.3 is my Carl Fisher reagent reading of Otto zero Barrett. Multiply, my MDF is 5. Multiply 100 is equal to divided by my sample weight is 100 milligram. Then my moisture is 26.5 of my sample. It depends on your sample weight. For troubleshooting, sometimes your reagent is not passed from this tubing, then please change this position like this. If your reagent is not passed, change this position. You can also set from this knob. This is the final demonstration of Otto Carl Fisher titrimeter. Thanks.